Blessed be the Lord, who made heaven and earth, who hath directed thee to the cutting off the head of the prince of our enemies. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Today we celebrate the great feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And there is sometimes a little bit of dispute among faithful which one is the greatest feast of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Some saying that it's today the feast of her Assumption into heaven, body and soul. And some say that it is the day of Immaculate Conception, when her life, which was pure, holy and immaculate from the very beginning, started in the womb of Saint Anne. But it seems most suitable to regard this feast of Assumption as the greatest of all holy and beautiful feasts of our Blessed Lady. Because just like Christ fulfilled and finished his work of redemption when he resurrected on Easter, so also Mary showed us our true end, that we also, like she was, who are creatures of God, we too one day will definitely rise from our graves, and those of his, that is God's faithful, will receive their heavenly reward and in the eternal paradise, just like our mother Mary did. So if the feast of Easter, when Christ resurrected, is the great feast of how good overcomes evil, so this feast of the Assumption of Mary is the great feast of consolation and hope, that even we who are children of Adam and born in sin, we too can follow her, namely Mary, all the way until eternal heaven. It is the very this feast of Assumption is also a very Catholic feast. For so many people who consider or call themselves Christians, this great honor and veneration which we give the Blessed Virgin Mary borders blasphemy. They say that you can only give honor and glory to God her Almighty. But for a Catholic, the veneration of Mary is never a problem. So much so did God, our Blessed Lord Jesus himself, venerate his Holy Mother, so that we should never be afraid to give all the possible honor and glory to her, because by doing so, we follow the footsteps and example of our Redeemer, Jesus Christ. And isn't that exactly what a Christian does, being a follower of Jesus Christ? To a Catholic, none of the dogmas, which Assumption is one of them, none of them causes any difficulties at all. For many Catholics, it might sometimes be hard to understand different teachings and regulations and different dogmas of the Church, but he has never any difficulties in accepting everything what Holy Mother Church defines and teaches to her children. And this Feast of Assumption gives us many beautiful reminders and teachings of our Christian faith, all of which we must believe, accept, and confess. It teaches us, first of all, the fall of our first parents, and it was necessary for Our Lady to be born so that Christ, man-God, might be born. And the only reason why we have our Lord, only reason why we have cross, only reason why we have redemption is sin. modern world doesn't want to hear to talk about sin. They say that every man is every man has dignity. Everyone is equal. Everybody is born good. But Christianity and Catholicism teaches something completely different. We are under the bondages of sin. And even though Christ has defeated death, Christ has defeated sin, we are still struggling here on earth to do the holy will of God in our own lives, because we want to avoid eternal punishment and to be rewarded in heaven. And in this great search and quest of ours, we have the help of our Blessed Virgin Mary. As said, and if she, who was one of the creatures of God, namely the greatest and the best creature there ever was, but still who had a beginning of existence, if she has been elevated to such great sanctity and honor, we also have hope. We too have expectation of heaven, as long as we follow her example, namely doing everything what her holy son Jesus tells us to do. Also, the Assumption gives us the teaching that our Blessed Virgin Mary's life came to fulfillment and came to its reward when she was assumed into heaven. Our Blessed Virgin Mary had to endure many, many sufferings here on earth. Her glorious Assumption was the reward, the presentation of the prize of all the great things she did here on earth, but also compensation of all the sufferings she had to endure. If you remember on her Christmas, the very life of our Lord Jesus on earth, it started in the midst of sorrows and persecution. Any mother who has ever seen her child suffering or being in some kind of a distress knows what a difficult, hard and agonizing situation that is. And that's why we give such an honor to Our Lady's sorrowful and immaculate heart. That heart has gone through so many sorrows, so many weepings, so many achings, and the reason for that is sin, because it is through sins of mankind that our Lord had to suffer, and for why Mary had to suffer as well. But it's not just sorrows, but also joys, which this Feast of Assumption teaches us. Even here on earth, Mary was the most beautiful, most perfect of all creations, but she still received something more, namely the great privilege of being taken up to heaven, body and soul. She was continuously growing in grace, even though she was full of grace. And it teaches us that, we are never done, so to speak, of being Catholics. We have never been graduated until we reach heaven. There is, if even Our Lady could always grow in grace, if even she could always do more, say extra prayers, say do extra acts of charity, how much more there is room in our souls always to grow in grace, always to do something extra, always show more charity to our friends and also to our enemies. And when we see our Blessed Virgin Mary reach the glories of paradise, she is meant to draw us with her. If we put our trust to her, if we ask her help in finally getting admitted to heaven, she, like a true mother, helps us. How many are the mothers in today's world who would show so much hope that their children who have been wandering off from faith, how many of them would wish that their children would ask them help, but that they would ask her her prayers, that they would come to her and say, Mother, I have wandered off. Please help me with your prayers. I am ready to hear your advice. And in that kind of a loving and good mother is our Blessed Virgin Mary as well. If we are sorrowful, if we have difficulties in this life, then we need to ask her. If we forget her, like so many who call themselves Christians have done, if we remember her, she will remember us. All we need to do is ask. And and if we need to wait for the answer, if we need to wait for her intercession, let us also carry that cross with the same loving kindness and patience. As she did. There's always room for us to do penance. There's also always room in us to sacrifice even more our own sorrows. And a Christian is always the one who carries his cross, does his do penance, and as our Lord has done penance for us. Penance should not be limited or restricted to Lent only. Lent should be time of extra penance. We sometimes think that our lives might be a little bit too easy, if we ever are in the tendency of taking a little bit lightly our obligations, our prayers, our duties, or our showing of charity, let us go and present ourselves to Our Lady and to carry some of the sorrows she has to endure during our times when sin is so much in rampant. The sufferings patiently borne are the greatest penance which we can do on this earth. And if we have the tender devotion of Mary, not only we are ready and willing to do our own penance on this earth, but she gives us patience to endure them and always grows us in charity to others. After all, our own life is meant to end up into heaven. We too are infallibly one day raising up from our graves, and our bodies are united into our souls again. Let us wait and expect that day with loving kindness and with holy expectation. If we call Blessed Virgin Mary our mother, if we are sorrowful for our sins and ready and willing to do to reparation for that, she is always our mother. She is our mother already here on this earth, and after our death, and during our death and after it, she will remain with us. She will console us like a true mother, and she will get from her dear Son Jesus for us as well a place in heaven together with her and the saints. May God bless you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.